Namaskar, I'm Ashok Vyas. In the Wide Angle with Ashok Vyas today, we have a special report on the event that was organized by Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan to mark 35 years of their being here in New York, serving Indian community and propagating the ideas which are enriching, enlightening, coming from the land of Bharat. In today's Wide Angle, we have a special report on an important event that was organized at the pier.
We are celebrating 35th anniversary of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan. This is, in my view, the most significant place for all of us. This particular institution came to USA when most of us were trying to come here either for a job or for money or for studying. Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan came here to share the knowledge and the wisdom of Indian civilization. When most of us came here to become millionaires, well, it's absolutely welcome. Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan came here to partake, you know, the value, priceless Indian wisdom to all of us. There is a Chinese saying, if you want to prepare for one season, 1 year, you grow rice or wheat. If you want to prepare something for a few generations, grow a mango tree. But if you want to prepare yourself for generations, for centuries, for millennia, then plant good people. In my view, Bharati Vidya Bhavan has been doing the work of planting good people all over the world. When we look at the name Bharatiya, you know, we have to come from Sadhguruji and Deepak Chopra's realization to the reality. We need to tell what Bharatiya means, and Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan has done that. Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan has also given us somebody in the New York City. When all of us are after status and position, there is a true guru amongst us, and that is Dr. Jairam. You know, he's a man whose feet I touch whenever I see him. That is the kind of guidance that this institution has received. It has become a center much before the Indian community emerged in Madison Square Garden. Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan has been the platform for all Indians. Much before Kaun Banega Karodopati became famous, Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan has been the platform, has given a platform to Amitabh Bachchan. Much before A.R. Rahman became what he is, Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan has invited him and honored him and, you know, spotted the talent. I'd like to congratulate Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan on this 35th anniversary. 35 years is very young, very youthful. They have a long journey. I would like to extend all the best for this institution's future journey. Thank you.
Bhavan ke prati in logon ka sneh hai, ye tabhi hota hai jab surkhru hota hai insaan, thokrein khane ke baad. रंग लाती है ना पत्थर में घिस जाने के बाद पत्थर में घिस गए बस यही है हम लोग इस बात को याद रखें भवन का आगे विकास होगा
नमस्कार जय भारत जय हिंद 35th एनिवर्सरी बर्थडे ऑफ भारतीय विद्या भवन अ ग्रेट इवेंट इन न्यूयॉर्क एंड आई हैव द प्लेजर ऑफ टॉकिंग टू डॉक्टर नवीन मेहता जी हु हैज बीन सो एक्टिव विद भवन as if we identify you with Bhavan. Tell me how this association started and how do you feel today after 35 years of Bhavan being here?
So this is 35 years in New York City, where that's the headquarters of America. Bhavan started 125 years ago. And Kanhaiyalal Manohar Munshi established the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan. The Bhavan New York is doing wonderful, and this is the one institute of the culture, art, literature, dance, and every values what we have in India. One day we were just sitting with Deepak Chopra, and he said, why don't you create a nice function, and I'll be very honored to come to your function. Sadhguru, he's a part of Bhavan all the time, and A.R. Rahman, If people remember, Bhavan was the first one to do the A.R. Rahman's concert in Nassau Coliseum in Long Island. That was the first concert ever done outside of India for A.R. Rahman. So all these people are very dedicated Bhavanite, and they are always ready to do something for the Bhavan. 35 years is a long time of one of the institution, which is non-profit, to be in the United States. We have our own headquarter on the 7th Avenue and 27th Street. We have almost 8,000 square feet, and we are totally associated in bringing the values and culture and heritage of Indian and Indians in America and the NRI to America, and we are here for the Indian community.
Wonderful. Dr. Mehta, slightly interesting question in terms of the ability of Bhavan to remain apolitical. I remember Bhavan has been the platform where many New Yorkers got to see great achievers from different fields, be it Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee to literary giants of all languages, to Amitabh Bachchan, Devanand, you name it. So now, when culture and political areas overlap, is it challenging sometimes to stay focused with the spirit of Bhavan and not get colored by any kind of political overtones?
We are representing the Indian values, not the politics. We have nothing to do with local politics or international politics. It has been record of Vidya Bhavan of New York that every prime minister and the presidents of India past, they have visited Bhavan. And every time they come to New York, the first thing they want to say that we want to visit Bhavan. Narendra Bhai Modi wanted to come to Bhavan, and he will be coming in next time, time permit. Abdul Kalam Saab, our president, he was dying to come to Bhavan, and he requested that I want all the children, 75% of my audience should be the children. So I think the Bhavan name, if I might say that one out of seven Indian in India has been touched by Bhavan. Bhavan is there. We have more than 130 institute. We have more than 150 centers in India, and there are so many colleges, so many universities, Bhavan handles them. The headquarter in Mumbai, it's on a Marine Drive, and Andheri is one of the biggest campus of any privately owned institution.
Lastly, Dr. Mehta, being a part of Bhavan has been, I'm sure, an enriching experience for you. Tell me, what is it that you learned by participating actively with various activities of Bhavan?
It makes me feel so humble. You forget about everything else and you feel dedicated to your own people, to your own community. It makes you feel that, yes, you are born to do something for the people, to bring our own heritage to the United States. You see, some of the younger generation, many times you feel they are lost. And that's the topic of today's discussion, the ancient knowledge in the new generation. We will have a wonderful topic, wonderful discussion by the saints, Sadhguruji and also Deepak Chopra. And of course, the Chandrika Tandon, now her name become the household in America, who has given $100 million to NYU to create engineering college. She will be the moderator. By the way, Chandrika is Bhavanite, and she is with Bhavan since 35 years. What an honor it is to bring all these people to the Indian people.
This important event included the presence of Chandrika Tandon, who is already known to the community as a philanthropist, and of course, as a Grammy nominee singer who has some albums related to soul, be it soul chants.
Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu, Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu. You can do better than this. Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu, Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu, Shakti Rupena Sastita, Shakti Namastasyai Namastasyai.
An incredible occasion and a great opportunity to be standing with BK and Ambiarji. You are so much a part and parcel of India in a global way, and Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan being here celebrating its 35th birthday of its presence in New York. How is the feeling for you, and the way you have seen activities of Bhavan, what would you say about the significance of the role that Bhavan has played?
Oh, this is, in fact, it's a very emotional moment in some ways, because I was posted in New York as a counselor during from 79 to 82. And this was around the time when the Bhavan New York, or Bhavan USA, was actually being set up, being established. And I recall very warmly Dr. Jayaraman and others who were there in the initial stages of the founding of the Bhavan USA. Since then, I think the Bhavan has traversed an incredible amount in terms of bringing a sensitivity to the larger cultural presence of India in the United States. Of course, there is a huge diaspora here, and of course, India, the presence of India is, in any case, well established in this country. But there are so many facets to what we would identify as Indianness and India, that the presence of the Bhavan was in many ways absolutely essential and critical. And I think over the years, the Bhavan has been doing its work in a very, very consistent and broad way. And I think that is perhaps the best quality of the Bhavan, whether it's bringing about, I think it was 10 years ago when Gulzar was brought, was the presence of Gulzar here, and then whether it was the Gita seminar, I recall it around a little less than 10 years ago when they had a seminar on Gita which was presided over, and the keynote address was given by Swami Dayanand Saraswati, who tragically is no more with us, and whose presence was so profound on that occasion. I think in many ways it was through the Bhavan that many of the public in New York were able to get and feel very immediately, in a very immediate sense, the larger cultural presence of India.
Taking the advantage of your presence and just to help us understand the way we are witnessing some of the unfolding of events which has prompted 40 plus literary figures to return the honors which were conferred upon them. And there are many statements from different quarters talking about the challenge to the communally harmonious spirit of India. How do you see these developments? Is it going to have a lasting dent on the image of India, or do you look at it as a passing phase and we learn and move on?
I see these fluctuations that take place as inevitable in a large democracy like India, whose very nature is that of diversity. There will be controversy, and also in a democratic situation that we are in, there will be differences of opinion. I think these will go, and there will be. It isn't necessary that all the issues that are thrown up in the course of these controversies are addressed openly and transparently, and I'm sure that they will eventually redound to the strengthening of our democracy.
श्री मंगल मूर्ति दर्शन मात्रे मन कामना पूर्ति जय देव जय देव
kept associated with Bhavan when it was just a vision, just a concept. And we were posted in New York when it became a reality. Bhavan was inaugurated, and since my husband was in the Foreign Service, we had to move. And then we came back in 2002, and the natural thing was to go back to Bhavan. And I take Sanskrit lessons there. My Guruji is Dr. Jayaraman. There are a lot of activities that we have been involved with. I have done a bit of singing for Bhavan also, Bhajan Sandhya. But what I really enjoy and my closest association with Bhavan is every Wednesday morning, a small group of us study Upanishad there. So this is a journey that has started long ago, and I hope it will take me somewhere in life.